Hey, what's happening, guys? Welcome back to FTD Speaks. Here's a video, a trending topic, actually. Bill Gates' daughter gets married to a Muslim. Whoa!
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. I hope you're well. Marriage is considered to be the most important day in our lives in the modern day world. Everyone's curious about food, flowers, ceremony, costumes, jewelry, friends, bride and bridegroom. In this day and age, we see marriage as a burden. Getting married early is almost a big problem. Well, I'll come back to this. Most of you guys would have seen this news of Jennifer Gates, daughter of Bill Gates' wedding. She is married to Nail Nassar, is an Egyptian-American professional equestrian, and this news is everywhere, brothers and sisters. Her people are very curious because she's the daughter of the richest man. Also, the groom is Egyptian-American Muslim. MashaAllah. It's reported that an Islamic ceremony was held on Friday night time in the backyard of the household's 142-acre property in North Salem, New York.
Okay.
Despite being the richest man, he didn't invite the whole world for it. If you are Desi, you know what exactly I'm talking about. There's nothing wrong with inviting so many people, but let's keep it simple. It's reported that wedding cost was $2 million USD.
Ooh.
It may be a huge amount for the world. Do you think it's a huge amount for them?
No.
Obviously not. They could have spent more and more, but they chose not to. Kept it simple and secret. MashaAllah. Honestly, I got an opportunity to talk about something related to marriage and weddings out of this incident. Let's not make the wedding a burden. You don't need to pull out a wedding of thousands of dollars just because your cousin or your friends are doing it. Especially when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you money, some social recognition where people look up to you. In this scenario, if you are keeping the wedding simple, trust me, you solved a complex problem in society. People will follow the example, inshallah. We all know the Islamic saying, the best marriage is that in which the least expenses are spent.
Oh, really?
If you want your marriage to be the best, you need to spend less. See how Islam makes our lives easier.
Spend less.
Subhanallah. There's a lot of effort and preparation for that wedding day. But the real preparation should be for your marriage, which will last not for a day, but for years, inshallah. It's important to fulfill the rights of your spouse. Yes, beauty plays a role, but if you go with appearance alone, probably you would regret it down the line. Money is a need, but if money and looks are the only things you are looking up to, you need to reconsider your choice. This is the person you are going to wake up next to for the rest of your life.
Mm-hmm.
This is the man or woman who is going to be a parent for your kids. It's more important to look for character, compatibility and compassion. The other important thing is he's married to Bill Gates' daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Status or lineage comes in. Our societies have already set the status for people. Some of us may not be well recognized. Maybe we aren't doing so good in life. What about our names and status? It's important to be priceless in the sight of God, Allah the Almighty. People may praise you and love you on the face, as long as you can benefit them. Are you single? Married? Considering marriage? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you the best spouse and put barakah in your married life. Make decisions wisely. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. That's it for today, guys. I hope you liked the video.
Oh my God, guys. I had no idea. Now, I'm somebody who I'm all up on the latest headlines and everything. And this one slipped me. I had no idea that Bill Gates' daughter married this man. And the fact that he's a Muslim also brings up some other questions too. Because I thought it was for Muslim men to only marry another Muslim woman or a Jewish woman or a Christian woman. And as far as I know, I don't think Bill Gates' daughter follows any particular religion. Then again, I could be wrong. Maybe she's Christian. Maybe she follows Judaism. I don't necessarily know, but I'll just a question that popped up, like, oh, what's her religion then? And even if she's not, I guess that's just something that they chose to do, but is it something that Islam frowns upon if a Muslim man marries a non-Muslim, Jewish, or Christian woman? You know, still learning about all these Islamic rules when it comes to marriage and things like that. And the message in this video is also really, really, really important because it stresses more so on the actual marriage, like choosing a spouse versus spending all of this money on a wedding, just for one big day, maybe two. Some cultures are like 3 or 4 or 5 days, but really, it's like you guys aren't necessarily compatible. You know, more time should be spent on actually choosing the right spouse and not necessarily just putting all this money into the wedding. Now, of course, for Bill Gates's daughter, right, $2 million isn't really anything. Bill Gates has billions of dollars, so $2 million is actually a drop. It's like spending $5, you know, for a wedding for him anyways, and or just even his family in general. I'm sure all of his children are going to inherit a lot of wealth and have inherited a lot of wealth. So either way, maybe Bill Gates didn't even put money towards his wedding. It's just his daughter herself. Just here you go, $2 million. That's it. And for them, it's not a big expense. That was mentioned in this video. But for people who don't have millions of dollars, you don't have to go all out with their wedding. Of course, there's still gonna be some expenses when it comes to a wedding, but for sure, you should never go in debt. I know when I got married, it was a very simple backyard wedding, very beautiful. You know, I have photos and videos on my Instagram, so you can follow me over there if you haven't, and then you could see get a little bit of an idea of what my wedding was like. So I'll link to my Instagram below in the video description section. And even that was still thousands of dollars. So just imagine if it was much, much bigger. But good thing is we never went into any debt. We just paid everything out of pocket and that was that. So it definitely made things a lot easier because not only we believe that we're the right spouses for each other, but also there was no real stress when it came to the wedding, and we weren't hurting financially to try to, you know, go in debt and borrow money just to cover the wedding costs. No, none of that. We just kept it as simple as possible. So I 100% agree with the message in this video. So guys, that's it for me. Let me know down below in the comment section, you know, are you married? Are you planning to get married? Are you single? Where are you at in the spectrum? And what are your thoughts about marriage? Do you think that it's not gonna happen for you? Do you never wanna get married? Is something that you hope for? Let me know all your thoughts about it down below. Thanks for hanging out with me here on FTD Speaks, guys, and I'll catch you tomorrow for another episode. Later.